All right, this is another consecutive integer problem. Twice the smallest of three consecutive odd integers is seven more than the largest. Find the integers. All right, there's a slight twist here. We're looking for odd integers. So keep in mind, if you an example of odd integers might be like, 9, 11, and 13. If you know the first odd integer, you're going to have to add two to get to the next one. And the next one, etc. If you only add one, you're going to get an even number for the next number. So keep that in mind as we define our integers. All right, so let's call the first number n. And you're saying that it's odd. In fact, you might want to write it like this. The first odd number is n. Then the second odd number, you have to add two. Think of an odd number in your head. To get to the next odd number, you're going to have to add 2. So the second odd number is n plus 2. And the third odd number, you're going to have to add 2 more, which will be n plus 4. So this is the defining your variables part of the problem. Then it says twice the smallest of these numbers is 7 more than the largest. So basically, sort of in words, it's sort of like saying twice the small odd, right, is 7 more than the largest. Okay, so you're going to add 7 to something. You're going to add 7 to the large odd number. All right, so let's see how we define the small odd. We said it was n, so the equation will just be 2n, right? Putting in n for the small odd. The large number is n plus 4, right? There's a large plus this 7. So we've got twice the smallest is 7 more than the largest odd. So now we can solve this by subtracting n from both sides to get the variables on one side and also add the 4 and 7 on the right-hand side of the equation. So n is 11. So it looks like our numbers are 11, 13, and 15, right? We're going up by twos to make sure we get all odd numbers. Now, we want to make sure this all checks and makes sense. It says twice the smallest is, well, what's twice the smallest? 22, right? That's twice the smallest. Is that the same thing as 7 more than the largest? Well, if you add 7 to the largest, you also get 15. So you're just checking it in words. You don't go back to your equation because maybe you wrote the wrong equation. So it looks like these are correct, and it is a word problem, so of course we want to write our answer in words. And it asked to find the integers. It didn't ask for the smallest or the largest or the middle one. Sometimes that's what it'll ask for. Make sure you answer the question. The integers are 11, 13, and 15. We showed all our work. We checked our answer. Awesome. All right, next problem. Find three consecutive even integers such that 3 times the middle integer is 4 more than the sum of the first and third. Again, we are looking for even integers. Remember, if you're looking for odd or even integer, odd or even integers, you've got to go up by twos, right? So we're going to define it just like we did the last one, except it better be even. So let's call the first one the first even n. Then the second or the middle one will be not n plus 1, but n plus 2. And the third will be n plus 4 because we are talking about three integers. Okay, now it says 3 times the middle integer is 4 more than the sum of the first and third. So it says 3 times whatever that middle number is, right, is 4 more than the sum of the first and third. So I've got to add the first and the third together, right? And then I've got to do 4 more in that. So this is, not really an algebraic equation, but I'm kind of putting it part English, part algebra, and then I'm going to look back and see how I defined each of those. So I've got 3 times the middle one. Now, what was the middle one? N plus 2. So I've got 3 times the m plus 2. That's what we have for the middle number. Remember to put it in parentheses because you're going to have to distribute that 3. And then we're going to add the first and third. Now, we don't really need the parentheses in this case. You could keep the parentheses around, but you don't need to. So the first number is n, right? And then plus the third number was n plus 4, right? Plus this other 4 hanging out at the end of the problem, right? Just so you could see, the first is n, the third is n plus 4, and then that other 4 I'm just writing right here. Okay, so now let's simplify each side of the equation and solve. You can always put this on pause and then come back, but I'm going to show the steps now. Distributive property on the left is 3n plus 6 because I'm doing 3 times n and 3 times 2. And on the right-hand side, I'm adding n plus n. Remember, that's 2n. It's not n squared. It's n plus n. 1n plus 1n is 2n plus 8. And then we'll go ahead and get the variables on the left and the constants on the right. So let's subtract 2n from both sides. And let's also subtract 6 from both sides at the same time. So I'm adding negative 2n minus 6 to both sides of the equation, and I get n equals 2. All right, now remember there were 3 numbers, so it looks like the numbers are going to be 2, 4, and 6, right? We were talking about even numbers. And by the way, if you came up with an odd number, it would be wrong because the question said you're supposed to find 3 even numbers. So if you come up with an odd one, it means they gave you a bogus problem or you made a mistake. So we've got 2, 4, and 6. Now, we hope that's the right answer, but let's see if it makes sense with the original problem. So we got 2, 4, and 6, right? Now it says, would these numbers be true? 3 times the middle integer, is that 4 more than the sum in the first and third? Okay, well, what's 3 times the middle integer? Okay, so we're just doing a little check here. What's 3 times the middle integer? Oh, that's going to be 12. All right. Is that the same thing as 4 more than the sum of the first and third? Well, the first and third, when I add those up, I get 8, and 4 more than that is also 12. So you know what? It does check out, right? So we check it out, going back up to the words, and then we write our answer. In words, because it's a word problem, the numbers, don't ever leave it as just n equals 2, because there was no n in the problem. You defined what n was so that you could figure out the answer to the problem. The numbers are 2, 4, and 6. And there we go.